Hey Diamonds, what's up? It's your boy Christopher Doc Reed, your favorite relationship and life coach out here. One more again, telling you what your father didn't tell you and your mother did not know. Ooh, I know you saw the title on this one and you was like, ooh, put the kids to bed because we're going to get into it. So for the subject of this one, I want to give you a frame of reference. I do. Do you remember this character? Okay, let me get that off. Okay, yeah. Remember Pepe Le Pew? The cartoon character. Now, why you want to hold up Pepe Le Pew when you're talking about sexual narcissists? Well, the reason that I'm doing that is because remember how charming Pepe Le Pew was? Oh, my darling, you know, and he had like the rose in his mouth and all of that kind of stuff. See, yeah, that's what the sexual narcissists will do, all right, to get you ensnared, okay? Because think about the dichotomy. This charming, okay, figure, but he's a skunk. Okay, so that's just to kind of give you a little frame of reference of what we're dealing with today. See, because the sexual narcissist, although very charming, okay, very alluring, there's that part of them, okay, that doesn't match that. So they use the sex as a tool. They use sex as a tool to impress you, to trap you, and to manipulate you, period. Now, there are a couple scenarios that we want to get into. One is, all right, and it's very ensnaring, all right? So you might have been in a relationship, a long relationship, a marriage, or whatever the case may be, that just had no intimacy. The intimacy was dead. It had maybe been dead for a year, a couple years, whatever. So then you come across this sexual narcissist after that relationship. And oh my God, all right? Because you might not even known that on the inside that you was just, everything was shut down. But then you get involved with the sexual narcissist and you feel alive again. You feel alive in ways that you never even thought was possible. Now your body responds to this sexual narcissist in ways that you did not know you could. Do you understand the impact that that can have? And guess what? With the sexual narcissist, which is his goal, all right, he's the only one that has ever made you feel this way. Your body awakens and now it craves this intimacy, this sex that you're having with the sexual narcissist. You feel like a crackhead, okay? And that's his goal anyway, to turn you into one, okay? You remember the movie, Spike Lee movie, She's Gotta Have It? Yes, that's what you turn into. But that was the goal all along. So now we get into the punishment. So now we start to withhold it from you. Oh my God, please don't do that, because now your body's craving it, all right? So that's one scenario. Other one is the sexual narcissist is very controlling. Now, they have an insane sex drive, many of them, okay, to the point where they want it multiple times a day, every single day. Now, they expect it whether you want to have it or not. It's not an option. I'm not asking, okay, forcing you into various sex acts that you never in a million years thought you would be into or do. Maybe threesomes or all kind of stuff. You know, Ephesians 4:19 says this, who being past feeling have given themselves over unto lasciviousness. Now, what does this mean? Okay, this means that there's no shame. They don't have any shame. There's no conscience. They're dead inside. They give themselves over into whatever sexual desires that they want to play in, okay? All right, that they want to engage in. All right, the rest of the scripture says this, to work all uncleanness with greediness. All that matters is what they want. They could care less about what you want. Okay, now sometimes for you, when you're with narcissists, you know it's chaotic and gaslighting and raging and all that. Sometimes the sex for you, that's the only time that there's peace, when he's not arguing. He's not making your life a living hell, all right? But keep in mind, it's never about the intimacy, all right? It's 100% physical. It's never emotional with them, all right? And they'll ignore you. After the intimacy is over, they'll ignore you. Just turn over and just won't. They ain't no cuddle time, so you can forget about that. So let's talk about this. How do you get out of this situation? If you're listening to me right now and you're like, oh my God, this is exactly the hell that I'm living in right now. It's like any other addiction, all right? See, there are a lot of you right now, you're dealing with a lot of shame. If you are dealing with a sexual narcissist, you're dealing with a lot of shame. Why? You haven't told anyone. You haven't told your friends the things that you have done and things he's made you do in this relationship. Okay. And you feel like I've become someone that I don't even recognize. Okay. But the reality is he made you do these things. It's not your fault. You thought you were getting involved with someone who genuinely cared. Okay. About you. All right. But keep in mind, Pepe Le Pew is a skunk. Skunks don't have friends. Why? Because they stink. Okay. So they got to present all this charm and all this other stuff and perfume and all this to hide the true intentions, okay, of what's really going on. Sir, you stink, okay, and nobody wants to be around you. But if they show you the true, okay, their true selves, they know no one wants to be around them, so they have to disguise it. What I need you to do, I need you to get away, and I need you to run, okay? Do not try in any way to rationalize it. All right. Do not try to do this, because empaths are notorious for doing that. Why did this happen? And I just try to understand and want to. No. Do not get caught up in all that. That will keep you in that situation. Now, he'll try to blame you. He'll try to say it's your fault. This ain't working because of you. But that's what narcissists do. Do not let him have access to you. All right. Because all it's going to do is trigger you. Keep in mind, you have to detox by distance. So you can detach, detox by distance. So you can detach. That's the only way that this is going to work. You have to go into detox, but you have to distance yourself from the source, from the crack cocaine. You know what I'm saying? If you become the sexual crackhead, all right, so that you can fully detach. Now, let me ask you this. Are you trapped in this situation with a sexual narcissist? All right. Has your body become addicted to this? All right. Now, are you afraid to leave? You know, point blank, you're just terrified that if I leave, I don't know if I'll ever feel this way, or I don't know if I'll ever experience this again with someone. What if it never happens? What if? Listen, let me tell you something. If this is what you're in right now, you know what I'm going to tell you to do. Hit your boy up. All right. Go to my website, ChristopherReed.org. All right. Schedule your free 30-minute consultation so we can talk about it. So we can talk about how coaching can help you to break the sexual addiction. All right. And it can be an addiction. Also, please join me every Wednesday in my closed Facebook group, The Diamond Mind, where I'm talking about the stuff that really matters to you. 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time every Wednesday. Last Wednesday, we talked about spotting warning signs of gaslighting and manipulation. What you got to understand is there are certain tools that narcissists use, okay, or manipulators use. And these tools are designed to trap you, all right, without you knowing. It doesn't work. Manipulation doesn't work if you see it coming. So the tools that they use, they disguise it so that you can't see it. But by the time you realize what's going on, they got you in their grips. All right. All right. And if you try to get away and you get away a little bit, they pull you back in. Those tools are designed to do that too. That's where the hoovering and all that comes from. So make sure you go to my website, learn how to join the Diamond Mind. Also, the video series that I did, Why He Married Her Instead of You. If you haven't seen this, you're missing out on a great treat, where the men tell, you know, the women all the secrets, you know, everything that's going on, why they do what they do, what they're looking for in a woman, the whole nine yards. So go to my website. You can check that out as well. So listen, I got to get out of here. Keep in mind, you know what? It's not your fault. He tricked you. He ensnared you, but you can't get out. I'm out of here, y'all. Peace.